Hello everyone, I am Kay and you are watching me play Danganronpa today. And, well, Sayaka got killed last time. And Monokuma says he absolutely has nothing to do with it. He didn't kill her. I mean, he kinda did by putting us all in this pool and forcing us to kill each other, but whatever. Let's see what we're going to do now.
I can promise you, I won't do anything that goes against the purpose of your school life here.
Listen up!
I'm famous at spam fights around the world for following the bad times one rule.
But...
then... who did it? Who killed her?
Come on!
You already know the answer.
Let me guess. It's one of us.
The one who killed her is... one of you.
Nobody had a reply for that. One of us killed Sayaka? Don't be stupid. That's...
Wah-wah?
Huh? What's the matter? You guys all look like you're about to see a dove get shot up with a Gatling gun. Don't you remember what I told you when this all began?
Yahoo!
One of you decided to kill Sayaka so that you could graduate. Someone's just following the rules. There's nothing wrong with that.
Well...
You're lying, right?
Of course he's lying. I'm telling you, he killed her.
Wrong.
Nope.
Sorry. One of you is now a bona fide killer.
If they wanted to, the one who did it could testify to that little fact.
What? Without thinking, I looked around at everyone. They all had the same look on their faces. Everyone looked at each other with a combination of fear, suspicion, and confusion.
Are you serious?
What is
someone,
this?
Someone killed someone!
It is amazing what some people are capable of.
Just hold on.
Hey, hold on. Don't just assume he's telling the truth.
Stop talking.
It's enough. Before we do anything else, I'd like to confirm something with the stuffed animal here. If one of us really did kill her, that person gets to graduate from the school, right?
Huh?
Come on.
Don't play dumb. That's what you said, isn't it? If you kill someone, you get to leave.
What?
Why are you laughing?
It's 'cause... you're just so naive. You think it's really that easy? You can just kill someone and waltz on out of here?
Hey!
You're super naive.
Now.
Devilishly naive. Hellishly naive. No, no, no. Real thing has just begun.
The real thing?
Now then.
Are you ready? Allow me to explain the second part of the rule regarding graduation. Just like I've explained before, you must kill someone if you want to leave. However, even if you do that, there's still one more part to the agreement you have to uphold, remember?
Then perhaps...
you're referring to rule number 6 of the school regulations. If you are the blackened that committed the murder, you can't be found out by the other students. That is what you're talking about, is it not?
In other words...
bingo! It's not enough to just kill someone, you have to actually get away with it!
So... if you do what he just said, and say that you killed her, you don't get to graduate.
Sweet. Which naturally means you need a system in place to assess whether or not it's been gotten away with.
Yahoo!
So, a certain amount of time after a murder has taken place, a class trial will begin.
Class trial?
Yeah. We'll begin a few hours after the murder. Everyone will gather together, including the blackened who committed the murder. And they and the spotless students will all engage in one big debate showdown.
During the trial, you'll have to present your arguments about who you think the blackened is. And once everything comes to an end, the outcome will be decided by popular vote! If the answer you've arrived at is correct, Only the one that disturbed your peace will be punished. The rest may continue their communal lives.
Only the one that disturbed your peace will be punished. Okay,
however, if you choose poorly,
I'm guessing everyone gets punished.
Then the one who got away with murder will survive, and the rest of you will receive your punishment. Which of course means your school life will come to an end.
Yeah, not your, just your school life, but your actual life as well.
As far as class trial rules go, that's all there is to it. Well...
So, what exactly is this punishment you keep talking about?
Oh, well, to put it simply,
what?
It's execution.
Execution?
What?
By execution, you mean?
Execution is execution. Execution!
Sonic.exe. The person who gets found out is supposed to play Sonic.exe, right?
Electric chair! Poison gas! Torn apart like a paper plane in a hurricane!
I feel like this is preferable to Sonic.exe. So, to make sure I understand, if we get the culprit right, then only they die, but if we get it wrong, how the rest of us get executed?
Smart little chimpanzee you are. Look at you. The plan you didn't do it without actually saying it.
What's basically what the outside world calls a major system or inquisition type thing. Is it the inquisition of a certain country? A European country to be exact? Would it be the Spanish Inquisition? No? Oh. Well, that's a shame. Wouldn't have expected that anyway.
Which means you'll be deciding who you think the killer is. Just carefully, because all your lives are on the line.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Let me just add the rule I just described to your handbook. Make sure to keep it in mind.
The new rule has been added to the regulations. Wait, hold on a second.
What are you talking?
You're freaking insane, you know that?
What the?
A class trial? What the hell is that? I don't want anything to do with it.
What's this?
Why not?
Stop it!
What do you mean why not? I don't have to waste my time trying to figure out who murdered someone.
What?
What? Are you saying you're not gonna participate in the trial? Only punishment awaits such blasphemy.
The hell are you talking about?
What? Punishment? I don't know, throw you in a deep, dark, scary prison or something.
Shut the hell up!
Shut the hell up, say whatever you want, I'm not gonna be part of this.
I don't
be
believe it! Stop it!
You're the one being selfish. Kill whoever you want, it's got nothing to do with me.
She was standing here before me, and trembling with fear.
And I won't get into such evil. It's my style to stick it out and resist to the very end. If you really want to get out of here, you don't have to go through me first.
She said that he came charging at us, although it was more of a waddle. But then...
Are you enjoying yourself now?
Okay, I kind of like how they just... I don't know, is that censored or did they actually just show... You know, not show her panties in this shop.
Are you? Violence against Headmaster Monokuma is not allowed. You violated a school regulation. I invoke the mighty summon spell. Help! To me, godly spear Gunnier.
And holy fuck, what the hell just happened?
This wasn't supposed to... Why? Me?
Suddenly, right at the end, her eyes shut wide open. And just like that, she never moved again.
No way!
What the? What? Don't! This can't be real.
No way!
Well, now.
Now I'm people, you will. Great power and meaning of a promise. I really wanted to keep a culture from popping up for no good reason, you know?
Yeah.
But I guess you all needed to be told a lesson after all. What an amazing promise. But now you guys understand, right?
Now you see just how serious I am. Defy me and you get shot full of holes, exploded, buried alive, disintegrated, etc.
Yeah, we get it. We have to play along or else we're dead.
So, if you don't want that to happen to you, you best obey those school regulations.
Shikara's body had been impaled with a bunch of spears. Unbelievable amount of blood started pouring out of her body. It was the first time I'd ever seen the moment someone's life came to an end. Nobody there could deny what they'd seen. Junko, who until just a second ago had been our friend, was dead. She died. She'd been murdered. In simpler terms, it was the death of a human being.
It's
really not all that shocking. She just died, that's all. Just went and died. It's no more remarkable than the inevitable demise of the entire human race. It's just as natural as the eventual end of the world itself. This isn't some superhero comic, so it's not like when you die you didn't really die. This is reality!
Why?
Why did you have to kill her? Didn't you say you would put her in prison or something?
Hmm. I changed my mind.
I knew.
No, you've been wanting to kill this entire time.
Say what?
Kill this entire time? Don't be silly. You can't kill time. Are you being metaphorical? Are you saying I wanted to waste time this whole time?
What?
Come on, what do you take me for? Monokuma?
Well, now.
Anyway, none of that matters right now. I have something I'd like to give you to help you in your search for the Blacken. This little file has all the information I've gathered about the death in question. I like to call it...
It's
the Monokuma file! I mean, naturally you guys are experts at this kind of thing, so you can only do so much with a corpse. So instead I've gathered up everything I know about the circumstances and cause of death. What's that? How do I know the cause of death, you ask? Just a surveillance camera's picked up the whole thing. I get to see it all go down.
So then...
Wait, so then, you know who killed Sayaka?
Of course I do.
I didn't. I couldn't possibly pass a fair and accurate judgment during the trial, now could I?
Correct.
That's a good point. The judge has to be able to make the proper decision. That's somehow comforting.
Well?
Now then, please put your full effort behind your investigation. After all, you don't have any choice but to give it your best shot. Seriously, you don't have a choice. Okay, so we'll meet up for the class trial in a little while.
And with that, Monokuma disappeared once again. He left us stunned and confused. He left us at a total loss. He left us with Junko's dead body growing colder right in front of us. And for who knows how long, nobody said a word. The fact that Sayaka and Junko were dead was a huge shock, of course. But there was more to it than that. There was also the idea that one of us had actually murdered someone. And that if we didn't find out who it was, we would all die here. We'd find ourselves in a situation where we couldn't help but look at each other with open suspicion. It was the worst situation imaginable. And yet, even in such a perversely terrible situation, she didn't show the slightest hint that it had gotten to her.
Hey.
There's no time to wallow in your depression. The worst thing we can do right now is lose all faith in each other. That would lead to the same disastrous result as having total faith in everyone else.
What?
Huh?
In other words...
Cooperation is absolutely key at this point. Who you decide to trust or not is, of course, up to you.
Continuing to think about and talk about the deceased certainly isn't going to help anything.
What the heck?
Saying stuff like that is just... How many times have I told you, anyone who can't adapt will die? Death is the only thing awaiting those who are unable or unwilling to adapt. If that happens, you only have yourself to blame.
That's terrible!
An awful thing to say, especially after what's happened.
Just a second.
Right now, exposing the killer is the most important thing. Because if we don't, we're all going to die. She's right. We need to begin our search right away.
Of course.
Either way, we can't run away from the situation, so we have no choice but to move forward.
What the heck?
We just have to do it, I guess. Whatever choice do we have?
No way in hell am I letting someone kill me. Alright, dammit, let's do this.
We just have to do it.
Everyone kept repeating that sentiment. They're using it like a mantra to give themselves strength. But they're right. We just have to do this. No matter how much we don't want to, we have no choice. If that's what it takes to survive, then that's what we have to do. On top of that, there was something I needed to find out. I had to know why Sayaka had to die. Why she had to be the one. I'm terrified to find out, but still, I have to know. Otherwise, I knew I'd never be able to accept her death. Which is why... I don't have any choice. I have to do this. So, what do we do now? Do we just leave first and check out her body or something? Let's ask Kyoko. Before we start searching for Sayaka's killer, we need to decide what to do about securing the crime scene. What do you mean? You're thinking of putting someone on guard duty so nobody can disturb the area, aren't you? After all, if the culprit decides to destroy the evidence, we're pretty much screwed.
Hey!
In that case, I don't mind doing it. I don't like how to think, anyway. I'll let you guys figure out who killed that chick. Okay, we can let Mondo look after the scene. No, we can't. Well, no. We can't just leave him there alone.
What?
Why the hell not?
Stop talking.
Isn't it obvious? If you were the culprit, what's the first thing you would do? By volunteering for guard duty, you're in a position to destroy all the evidence you want.
What?
Fuck you!
So then.
Fine. Then I'll stay there on guard duty as well. That way there is no problem.
You play a core base defense with the two of them. Your game stands there totally OP.
Since we won't be able to help investigate, we're putting our faith in the rest of you. I'm still pretty freaked out, but I'll try.
Just a second.
Hold on. Before we begin the investigation, isn't there something else we need to discuss?
Oh, yeah.
Is there? I guess the file.
Anyway.
We're going to find out who the killer is, because if we don't, we're all going to die here. Well, you are kind of dry, aren't you? Is this really happening?
Don't fuck with me.
Screw that piece of shit, Bear.
What the heck?
I hate this, but still, we don't have a choice. We have to figure out who did it, or else we're all dead.
Oh.
So you finally noticed.
What the crap?
Huh? Noticed what?
I was looking through the Monokuma file we received. And that is something very obvious and very unusual. What are you talking about? Go ahead, take a look. Notice anything interesting about where Sayaka died? She died in Makoto's dorm. She's right.
Could it be? All at once, everyone's gaze turned to me. Hold on a second, you've got it all wrong. For just one night, I traded rooms with her. I did it because she was afraid.
What the heck?
You expect us to believe that? Just tell us the truth.
Look at everyone's eyes had done a complete 180 from just a few minutes earlier. The feeling of suspicion and fear had returned, in other words...
I did it?
Well, I feel like I would know if I did it. We need to hurry up and figure out who the culprit is. Okay, so do we have everything now? Apparently we do. How do I? I'm trying to check the Monokuma file, but I can't seem to find it. I gently place my hand on Junko's lifeless body. I touch the wrist to check for pulse like they do in movies and stuff, but you know, she's been pierced 5 times. She really is dead. If there was anything else to say, she was gone. I don't know why you even bothered to check. After those injuries and losing that much blood, frankly, I'd be shocked if she did survive something like that. Hold on. Hold on. Wait a second. She's dead? Then that means...
What?
That means everything that's happened so far is real? It's no joke or whatever? It's really real?
Hell no.
Someone save me! Let me out of here! Somebody help me!
What's your problem?
You're just now accepting that?
So then...
Are we all done talking? We need to begin our investigation soon. At this point, we should split up. We need to get to the bottom of this and find out who killed Sayaka. We'll have to collect clues to form a foundation, then construct an argument to come to a final decision. If we get this wrong...
So...
Well, do I really have to say anymore?
Perhaps you need...
I'd rather you didn't know.
Goodbye.
Everyone, pray for good luck. With that, Kyoko hurried out of the gym.
Goodbye.
I'll be going too. And just like Kyoko, he was gone before we realized it.
Yo!
Oh yeah, on guard duty, huh? Better head to the scene of the crime.
That's right.
Hey, damn it!
Let me just say this right now. If whatever son of a bitch did this is here right now, and they're thinking of destroying that evidence,
you're fucking dead.
They better not let me find him. Let's get to trial and cave their goddamn skull in myself. I'm serious. I will fuck them up.
Letting his deadly words hang in the air, he and Sakura ran off. But, I mean, we're not detectives or anything, you know? And we're gonna investigate a murder? How do we even do something like that?
Anyway!
We don't really have to do anything in particular. We already know who killed Sayaka. What are you implying?
This is very suspicious.
You. I'm telling you, it wasn't me. Don't come any closer. Are you gonna kill me next? Well, I guess it wouldn't hurt to give it a shot. It's not for sure that Makoto's killed it yet. What do you mean, give it a shot? You mean, killing Toko? I'd give that a shot.
That's true. We may as well at least check, just to check.
Even if I wanted to, I couldn't help but investigate.
Aww.
Wait, why not? I'm not good with the blood. All it takes is... one glimpse and I black out.
Oh yeah?
Well, whatever. I don't think anything was expecting much from you anyway. Alright, I guess I better get going. No, wait, don't go yet. You have to hear me out. But it was pointless. Everyone had already left. Their parting looks at me still had been filled with suspicion. Does everyone really think I'm the killer? How did it turn out like this? Seriously, I got it all wrong. Why do they have to suspect me? I have to do something. Otherwise, everyone will...
Execution is... Execution! Execution!
You're putting the cute in execution, aren't you?
Electric chair!
Already heard that. I can't let that happen. I can't let things turn out the way my Puma wants. All I have to do is find out who really did it. Who really killed Sayaka. Investigate. I guess I should look through the Monokuma file we got before. The victim was Sayaka Maezono. The time of death was estimated to be around 1:30 AM. The body was discovered in Makoto's room in the dormitory. All evidence suggests that the death took place in the bathroom.
cause of death was a stab wound to the abdomen. There was also an injury to the right wrist. Specifically, the wrist appears to have suffered a fracture. We have no choice but to push forward if we want to find out what happened. Somehow, and to find out the truth, so we can all survive. And for Sayaka, I have to find out how she was killed. Onokuma file number 1 has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Leave the gym. Yeah, the first thing I want to do... I actually want to go to the scene of the crime. Which means, where can I even teleport to? I don't know. Nowhere? Because we can't, because we're in the investigation. First of all, I should head to the scene of the crime, my room. Don't make any progress without investigating there. So I headed to my room, where Sayaka's corpse still remained. Oh, that's why I couldn't jump. That is why I couldn't teleport. I'd better examine the state of my room a little bit closer. It might reveal something new. Well, we have a key here. Key on the ground, it has my name on it, so it must be my room key. If I remember correctly... Oh, that's right, we'll have to trade keys. When we switched rooms, we switched keys too. So Sayaka would have had the key here in my room the entire time. But wait, if that's true, then... How did the killer get into the room in the first place? Could Sayaka have forgotten to lock the door? No, that seems impossible. Same goes for you, Sayaka. No matter who it is, don't open your door for anyone. Even if I'm sure it's you, I absolutely won't open it. Otherwise, what's the point of even switching? After saying that, there's no way she would have forgotten to lock it or open it for any reason. Well, maybe she dropped a key somewhere and someone else grabbed it or something. No, that's not possible either. Sayaka was in here when we switched rooms. And with how scared she was, she wouldn't have gone walking around, so she couldn't have dropped it. So, how did the killer... Switching rooms has been added to the truth bullet sections. Okay, what else we got? We got the broken sword. This is replica sword I brought back for self-defense. Does this mean it was used in the attack somehow? And plus, the sword's been taken out, so it's just a sheath, but... Huh? There's some scratches on the sheath. It must have been made with something sharp. But how did the sheath get scratched up in the first place? Even if someone used a sword during the struggle, it doesn't make sense for the sheath to be damaged. I mean, if you're gonna attack someone with a sword, the first thing you do is unsheath it. Maybe sheath like this would only get in the way. It could just slide out in the middle of the fight. So, why are there scratches on the sheath? This is the replica sword I brought back for self-defense. Does this mean it was used in the attack somehow? And plus, it's been taken out of its sheath. And actually, look at the blade itself till now. I shouldn't be surprised, it's coated in gold too. On top of that, some of the gold coating has come off part of the blade and the handle. Yeah, the handle especially is missing a lot of its coating. Remember, the coating sticks to you even if you just touch it a little bit. So someone must have actually used it. Huh? Looking at the lint roller, it looks like there's way less than there was before. Did Sayaka see how dirty my room was and decide to clean up a little? There are gouges in the bed, like someone attacked it. What the hell happened here? You got anything?
By the way.
You know, I realized something while I was on guard duty. The killer could have already destroyed some evidence, right? Before anyone found the body, I mean. There's a trash room here in the dorms, right? They could have tossed some stuff in there. Yeah, that's definitely possible.
You son of a bitch!
Dirty bastard! Anyone who raises their hand to a woman is scum that deserves death. That's what my brother taught me.
You're fucking dead!
If I ever find a son of a bitch that did this, I'm gonna pound his goddamn face in. But what if it was a girl that did it?
Yo.
That'll all get sorted out when the time comes.
You have no idea what you're going to do then, right? There are scratches and gouges on my walls and bed. Is that evidence of a struggle? It looks like there must have been some kind of fight in my room. I mean, I was right there in the other room. If only I'd heard something.
Wait.
That would not have been possible.
Huh?
Don't you remember? All of our rooms are completely soundproof. So something could happen in the room right next to you, and there's no way you could know.
Well,
perhaps this was a member of Monokuma's strategy, creating an ideal setting for murder. Evidence of a struggle, so... Anything else? Kyoko, you got something? Hey, Kyoko. I quietly called her name while she was investigating the area. But...
What are you doing? Isn't it obvious?
No, not really.
No, not really. I'm searching. Searching?
She was down on her knees, carefully inspecting every inch of my room.
Did you lose a contact or something?
I'm pretty sure she's searching for evidence. I don't know what she's doing exactly, but she seems to be concentrating pretty hard on it.
You said hard on.
But a few seconds later, she suddenly stood up straight and said...
Listen.
Are you a clean freak?
Huh?
No, I don't think so, but what? Nodding, she glanced around my room one more time.
I see.
Interesting. What's interesting?
Hey.
Just as I suspected, there's something very unusual about your room. What would that be? What do you mean?
So...
I searched your floor from one corner to another, and I didn't find a single strand of hair.
Really?
Indeed.
And then one hair from the victim, and then one hair from you, even though you've been living in here. You know, don't you mention it? I noticed something while I was looking around before. Looked like the lint ruler. Looked like the lint roller in my room had been used, but I never touched it. But someone had used it to...
I see.
Very interesting. Your room didn't have a single hair in it, and someone used your lint roller without your knowledge. In other words, someone other than you came in and scrubbed your room clean. Was it a silent killer or the killer?
Well?
That's the question, isn't it? Makoto's room cleanliness has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. Okay, is that everything in here? There's scratches and gouges on my walls and, yeah, evidence of a struggle. Okay, can I go into the bathroom now? Should look around here first. I can check other spots later.
No, I cannot.
Sakura, do you think I'm guilty too?
Hey.
I try not to make assumptions like that. I simply don't know whether or not you did this.
Hmm.
Whatever decision the rest of you come up with, I will follow your lead. I see. I should check the room first of all. Yeah, that's what I wanted to do, but I... Didn't mean to talk to Sakura again. There we go, that's probably it, right? It's the display stand the sword was on. Okay, that's not it, so... Notepad is still here, but I don't think it's relevant right now. The toolkit is still inside the drawer. I don't see any evidence that it's been used at all. Makes sense, I guess. I mean, it's mine, and I haven't had any reason to open it. I can't even imagine a situation where I'd need a toolkit like this.
Yo.
Yeah, seriously. Oh, Mom.
What?
When exactly in the mood to be building fucking furniture, right? So you haven't used yours either, then?
What?
That's just me. Nobody's busted theirs out yet, as far as I know. Actually, we were talking about it yesterday.
By the way.
None of the guys have opened their toolkits yet, because, like, why the hell would we? So nobody used the toolkit, eh? So is that everything now? The bathroom. On the other side of this door. No, I can't let it get to me. I can't afford to freeze up now. If
Forcing myself to push my panic down, I stepped into the bathroom. Looking at her made it painfully clear it wasn't a dream or an illusion. She had lost everything that made her, her. Sayaka. All at once I was overcome with dizziness, nausea, the urge to burst into tears, stomach pains, toothaches, fucking shoulder pain. But I can't hesitate now. Why? Why did Sayaka have to die? I have to uncover the truth. I have to find out what happened. I wanted to give up. I wanted to collapse, but that thought helped me up and supported me. So let's take a look at her body first. I told myself I simply couldn't face what I saw, but now it's no time to think like that. I pulled up the Monokuma file to verify what it said about her body. Some sort of sharp object has been thrust into her stomach. That must have been the killing blow. But whatever they used to kill her, where did they get it? That's definitely something I should look into later. Also, according to the Monokuma file, Sayaka's right wrist is broken. Her wrist does look swollen and bloody, that's for sure. But there's something sort of glittery there on her wrist too. Right there where her wrist is all swollen, there's something glittery. It definitely concerns me. Another thing that concerns me is... there's some blood on her left index finger, but that's it. Palms of both her hands are totally spotless, so how come only her left finger? Sayaka's wrist has been added to the proof bullet section of your handbook. The stab wound in her stomach is what killed her, so when she broke her wrist, that must have happened earlier on. I mean, how would her wrist get broken after she'd already been killed? So it's very possible she broke her wrist during the struggle. The killer attacked Sayaka in the main room, which is open, which is when her wrist got broken. After that, the killer cornered her in the bathroom, where they inflicted a deadly wound. You know, he could have just attacked her afterwards, or she. Looked past Sayaka to the wall behind her, and there I saw... what? Written in blood were the numbers 11037. Did Sayaka do this? I guess that's all there is to see here. Water for the showers gets turned off at night time. Yeah, which means... the killer couldn't wash away the blood. Looks like you found it, right, Makoto? The bloody numbers? It's most likely Sayaka's dying message. What do you mean by dying message? What do you mean? She wrote that as a hint? To her killer, probably. It's something a victim writes right before they die. Usually it's a way to tell people who killed them. So, Sayaka was killed by 11037. Generally, whoever writes it doesn't make it totally obvious. They'll either write it somewhere the killer would notice, or write it out in code or something. Wow, that's pretty incredible.
Hey.
Have you ever heard of Elric Queen? Who? Never mind. Well, now I'm curious. Who's Ellery Queen? Also, you had something else to say, right? Bloody numbers? I've never seen something written in blood before. It really was her final message. It's as if she wrote it with life itself.
Right.
I hear you often talk like an aspiring poet. But the numbers she wrote, what do they mean? 11037. I have no idea what that could possibly mean.
So...
the way she wrote the numbers makes me think she wanted to use her body to block them. If she wrote them in that location while she was sitting the way we found her, then she must have wrote them by turning only her hand toward the wall. If you were to write something in that position, do you know what the result would be? The result?
Well...
think about it. You're not gonna tell me?
Makoto.
I need to uncover the mystery of this case yourself. Otherwise, the case will end and you'll remain unconvinced. I have no idea what you're trying to say, but it's obvious you're not going to tell me. Dying message has been added to the truth bullet section of your handbook. It sounds like Kyoko knows what Sayaka's dying message means. But honestly, I have no idea. Oh, I know who I should talk to. When it comes to numbers, who better to ask than the ultimate programmer?
Makoto.
There's one other thing I wanted to ask you about. You know how the door to your bathroom got broken?
Broken?
Oh, you mean how it gets stuck?
What?
Gets stuck? Yeah, I guess I'm the only one, but the door doesn't fit in the frame quite right. When I first tried to use it, I thought it was just locked. But once you learn the trick, it opens no problem. Bathroom door frame has been entered to the truth bullet section of your handbook.
Correct.
So the door doesn't quite fit the frame, huh? But actually, I'm referring to the broken doorknob. Huh? Doorknob?
That's right.
You didn't notice. Well, just try closing the bathroom door. I'm sure you'll see right away what I'm talking about. I did what Kyoko said and shut the bathroom door. Huh? The doorknob?
There is no spoon. I mean, there is no doorknob.
What the heck? Doorknob's practically about to fall off. Why is it like this?
It would seem...
Someone must have used a screwdriver or something similar to unscrew it. Whatever it was, it's obvious this was intentional.
What? Was intentional? Why would someone want to do that?
So...
I guess maybe they were trying to get the door unlocked and ended up breaking the whole thing. But the bathroom doesn't have a lock on it. Only the girls' bathrooms can lock, right? She stood there for a while, lost in thought. And apparently struck with a sudden realization, she shot a question at me.
Just a second.
I have just one more question for you. You mentioned earlier that your bathroom door would get stuck, right? Did you tell anyone about that?
Well, I only told Sayaka.
Well, I did tell Sayaka about it last time when we switched rooms. So what you're saying is only you and Sayaka knew about it.
Hmm,
interesting. She had the slightest hint of a smirk on her face. I get the sense that she was really starting to get into all this.
I see.
And that clears that up.
Huh? What clears what up? I'm so lost.
Goodbye.
Well, see you later. As if forgetting I was ever even there, she suddenly turned and left the room.
Bathroom doorknob has been added to the truth bullet section.
I still don't really understand any of this, but I've already given my room a good once over. Maybe I should look around somewhere else. I should start looking into where the murder weapon might have come from, and also, I should look into the DVD Sayaka got. With Sayaka dead, I have no choice but to see for myself what was in that video. And on top of that, I'm sure there's some other areas worth checking out too. Maybe I should see what everyone else thinks, if they'll even talk to me, that is. You got anything to say?
By the way.
You know, okay.
You son of
nothing new. Okay, let's get out of here. Hold on, what? That's weird. Huh? This is Sayaka's room, right? But the nameplate has my name on it.
Very strange.
So, why was Sayaka in your room when she was killed? Could it be because you are the culprit?
No, you've got it all wrong. Sayaka and I switched rooms last night.
He didn't even try to hide the suspicion on his face. Even if what you say is the absolute truth, you're still responsible for her death, wouldn't you say?
Huh?
After all, she wouldn't have died if she hadn't switched rooms with you, right?
The reason Sayaka was killed is because I suggested we switch rooms? She's dead because of me? Then it should have been me that died?
Well, all we can say right now is that it's a possibility.
If that's really true, then I...
Dude, you are fucking heartless.
This is definitely my room, but the nameplate has Sayaka's name. The nameplates on my room and Sayaka's room were switched? So After all that effort I put into switching rooms without anyone knowing was totally pointless. But why would anyone do that? I'm sure we're going to find out eventually. The very first thing is the murder weapon. Where would you get the murder weapon? If not back here. It looked like a kitchen knife to me. There are all kinds of kitchen knives here, big to small, but looks like one of them is missing. Was it missing from the very beginning, or... Better see if anyone here knows more about it. Kitchen knife set. Let's see, maybe she knows something. Hey, so, did you notice that one of the kitchen knives is missing from the dining hall?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, weird, huh? I thought it was kind of strange. The knife just suddenly disappearing like that. Oh, so it wasn't missing from the beginning?
That's right.
Nope, I have to remember they were all lined up in a nice neat row. So, when did you notice one of them had disappeared?
Well,
when did you get some tea from the kitchen last night and all the knives were still there? When I finished my tea and went back into the kitchen to wash my glass, one of the knives was gone. So you're saying the knife disappeared while you were drinking your tea in the dining hall? Yeah, in other words, you were right there in the dining hall when someone came and took it. Then you should be able to say for sure. I can tell everyone I didn't come to the dining hall last night. Which proves I didn't take it! Hey, by the way, did you really kill Sayaka? What? Of course not! I would never! Hina, did you really think I murdered her? Well, she was killed in your room, right? So, I mean, you guys were supposed to be friends, right? But you still killed her. On the other hand, two people becoming good friends, then one killing the other is a classic drama setup. So we considered everything together? I honestly have no idea. Wow, you seem to be very sure that I actually did it. Which is nice. Alright, let's talk to the ultimate programmer. If I can manage to find him. Alright, to the AV room then. Time to check out that DVD. Wait, did I pick it up actually, or... is it still in the trash? Still in the trash. God damn it. Then I'm going to talk to him, to her first. Why did I say him? Hey Chihiro, I was hoping I could ask you something.
Huh?
Oh? What is it? Before she died, Sayaka left a message. She wrote out the numbers 11037. Do you have any idea what these numbers might mean? Like, could they be a code or something? Sorry, no. Chihiro slowly shook her head.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. I just don't know. Okay, well, don't worry about it. Thanks anyway for trying. Even she doesn't know. Or could she maybe know more than she's letting on? No, couldn't be. Chihiro knows nothing about that, alright? Get into Sayaka's room, where my name is.
blade is hanging for reasons unknown. There can only be one thing in a trash can. Yep, the DVD with Sayaka's name on it. Sayaka got really upset after seeing whatever was in that video. I wonder, what did she see? Might not be directly related to the case, but it might be worth checking out anyway. I'm sorry, Sayaka. I need to bow on this DVD. And I know you can't ask her anymore what's on it, but I don't know if she would agree to this. Alright, let's see what's on it. I should be able to use this to see what's on the DVD. DVD that Sayaka threw in the garbage. I sat down in front of the screen and put the DVD in the player. I pushed play and the screen was dark for a few seconds, but then an image slowly appeared. It looked like some kind of concert. And standing on stage front and center was a face I recognized all too well. Sayaka. She was there along with the friends she said had been important to her. She was positively glowing there in front of the crowd, so full of life. Seeing that image made it even harder to accept. Except that she was dead. My vision started to blur and darken, and then the voice I'd come to despise so much began to float out of the speakers.
Sayaka Maizono, the ultimate pop sensation, lead singer for a world-famous all-girl pop band. For these girls, the glowing spotlight only made them that much more beautiful.
Suddenly the screen went dark, and in the next moment, I saw something I could hardly believe. What the? Sayaka had disappeared from the stage, which was now in ruins. But what I noticed even more than that was the figures of the other girls who had all simply collapsed.
This ultra-successful team suddenly fell apart. None of them will ever perform on stage again. None of them will ever feel the warmth of the spotlight. For Sayaka, there's simply nowhere for her to return to. So here's the billion-dollar question. What, oh what, could have caused the group to go to pieces?
Look for the answer after graduation. Without warning, the video cut off. What the hell? That wasn't real, right? They're a super famous pop girl. Everyone knows who they are. Is he trying to say he was even able to get to them? If it really did happen, everyone in the outside world must be going crazy. What kind of person would take things this far? Okay, so what else do we do?
Listen to me!
We have a second, Makoto. I've uncovered something most unusual. The door to everyone's dorms has a nameplate on it to show whose room it is, right?
You hear me?
Well, it just so happens. Wait, no. You might be the killer yourself. I can't tell you anything.
Got it!
Forget everything I just said. Forget, babe!
Sorry, just a little low joke. Even I do jokes sometimes. Wow, you're kind of a jerk, you know that? If I remember correctly, Celeste is down here. So, do you have any clues or anything? What kind of clues? Clues? Just disagree, we do not know who the culprit is, and leave it at that. Whatever secrets I may have, I don't intend on revealing anything until the class trial. Okay then, do you have any suggestions for where I should start looking? So annoying, must you fumble around fishing blindly for clues? I suppose it wouldn't hurt to give you a little hint. The scene of a crime, naturally, but I think the trash room is also worth looking into.
The trash room?
It is the perfect place to destroy evidence. However, there's one little problem.
Which is?
As for me?
The place is filthy. I would rather die than sit that foot in there. I'm trusting all of you to conduct a thorough investigation on my behalf. That's...
Okay.
So, the trash room. Which is over here. Well, as you can see, there's a sturdy gate here. No way to get past it.
Monokuma appears!
End of the line!
The trash room? This is where all the trash in the school eventually winds up. How do you get this gate open?
No, no! You can't go any further!
No. No entry beyond this point. I need a person with cleaning duties allowed in. Cleaning duties?
No! You can't go any further!
No! No entry beyond this point. I need a person with cleaning duties allowed in. Who's on cleaning duty?
No! You can't go any further!
You are repeating yourself. This is stupid. It's faster just to go around and ask.
No! You can't go any further!
Oh, shit your face. Cleaning duty. Leave the area. So we have to find out who's on cleaning duty now, eh? Okay, you. I'm looking for whoever's on cleaning duty.
Cleaning duty?
As a matter of fact, that's me.
Why do you ask?
Just so happens Monokuma talked to me yesterday and asked me to take care of it. Once I'm on a cleaning duty, the school will be flooded with trash in no time. So I formally applied for your position. I was going to start this morning, but after what happened, I haven't had a chance to get started. And since you're on cleaning duty, you can open the gate and throw out the trash room.
Here we go!
Of course! My job to gather up all the garbage and toss it in the trash room. And to do that, they gave me the key for the trash room gate.
Mm-hmm.
You're supposed to rotate once a week, so eventually you'll be in charge.
Very strange.
Wait, hold on. The key to get in the trash room, and only the person on cleaning duty has access to the key. What's the point of going through all that trouble? Why not just leave the trash room open all the time so we can all throw things out whenever we want? That does seem more convenient.
So in other words...
Actually...
So that's it.
That must be why. Anyone could go in and out of the trash room whenever they wanted. The destroying evidence would be easy. Drill would disappear and things would become boring. Boring?
Hey, listen!
Anyway, more important than that...
Hey, you bastard!
Hey, fatty, why'd you want the cleaning duty gig anyway?
Oh,
I just decided to volunteer for something I knew no one else would want to do. What's big to you?
You...
Liar, I know you did it.
Is it? Like...
I'm gonna dig through all the gold trash, looking for, you know, and poking around at it.
There's no way to think about this with common sense kind
of... You know what I mean.
There's all kind of trash diggers like that. Maybe you'll get tired of 2D and then turn it.
I would never get tired
of 2D. After spending a significant amount of time comparing 2D and 3D, I voluntarily choose 2D. The only thing 3D is good for is to shower love and affection on 2D. Oh, and PVC figures.
Give me a break.
Are you not totally embarrassed to say stuff like that?
Hmm.
You're so worried about Fifuma's questionable morality, there's a very easy solution. Whenever a guy's cleaning duty, Sakura can accompany them from picking up the trash and disposing of it.
What? What?
If you're as innocent as you claim, where's the harm in it? That's not how it's supposed to. Anyway, on another topic, Ifumi, since you were on cleaning duty, I have a favor to ask.
You know you said you want to join my party.
Sorry, but you haven't triggered that flag yet. I mean, you haven't helped me recover from a past trauma or save a village or beat a boss. No, nothing like that. I was just helping get into the trash room and look around.
Okay.
So easy. So Ifumi and I headed down to the trash room. You'd like me to open the gate, wouldn't you? You know, when I look at it, it makes me think. He said he killed his wife, he learned how to get by on the internet, but he never stopped dreaming. Get busy living or get busy dying, he said, so him and Rita, they found themselves a way out. Whatever, please just hurry up.
Okie dokie, leave it to me.
Fumi pulled the key out of his pocket and used it to flip the switch next to the gate. And then...
Mr. Naegi!
However, Mr. Naegi,
surely
you aren't playing that you used the trash room to destroy evidence, are you? You fiend, you planned this all along. No. I just wanted to see if the actual killer had tried to destroy any evidence or not. But the actual killer is you, isn't it? You want to see if you left anything behind. Maybe a parallel wall? Whatever, let's just hurry up and keep looking. This is the incinerator. It's way in the back part of the trash room. It's a good 30 feet from here to see. Do you see the green and yellow buttons next to the mouth of the incinerator?
Yes, indeed.
It's a pretty simple setup. You press the green button to get it going, and the yellow button to turn it off. Sooner or later, you'll be on cleaning duty, so make sure you learn this before you leave. Okay. Someone turned the incinerator on. Very strange. I'm quite certain it was off last time I was down here. Perhaps it was the work of a fairy. Ifumi, do you realize what you just said?
Huh?
The fairy? No, you said that last time you were here the incinerator was off. Yes, about that there can be no mistake. If I've got one thing going for me, it's a memory.
I feel it.
Yesterday, as soon as I was appointed, I came down to check the place out. Definitely wasn't on bad. I haven't been back to the trash room since then. Since I'm the only one who has a key to open the gate.
No suspicion.
It should be impossible for the incinerator to be on, yet. So that means someone was able to switch on the incinerator without opening the gate. But how is that possible? What do we have here? There are shards of broken glass scattered around that dropped incinerator. Looks like it used to be some kind of glass ball, just about big enough to fit in the palm of your hand.
Is this
Jack? You know what this is? They say if you connect all seven, the dragon will appear and grant you a single wish. Can you decide? It's the kind of thing you might see on any big city street corner. Eat into it and we'll show you a glimpse of the future. Isn't like that mean of you who was on that quest to find it one guy? Yeah, I get what you're trying to say, but who did this particular ball belong to? There's only one person it could be. They should all still be in the gym. I'd better go find out for sure. Alright, the crystal ball. There's something on the ground in front of the incinerator. Looks like a burnt piece of something.
Burnt piece?
Like a hunk? Like a hunk of burning lamp? Pretty sure that's not it. Anyway, this is... looks like a piece of glove, like the shape. It's part of the sleeve from a button-up shirt. Now that I look at it, that's definitely blood on the cuff, which means... it's all that's left of some of the evidence the killer destroyed. There are lots of people here with white button-up shirts. Enough by itself to figure out who the killer is. Burnt shirt piece.
The whole thing is quite strange indeed. When they were here last, the incinerator was off, and those last shots of burnt clothes weren't.
Does it only mean it's Maggie?
You be confessing soon?
Why me?
Everyone already knows you did it. All the mysteries are being solved one by one.
Sounds like he's living out one of his comic book fantasies. The green button turns it on and the yellow button turns it off. Or so it seems that way. So I guess that should be everything, right?
Mr. Niggy, you seem a little down.
Huh? Really?
If you need help lifting your spirits, call me anytime.
Come on, come
on. There are kinds of smart stuff that might help cheer you up. Okay, well, you know what? I'm out. I will go to the gym. I'm going to continue this until, you know, until we get to the juicy part. I know we've already gone on for over an hour, but whatever. We're going to have to hold on until then. Alright, hero. Can I ask you something?
No, I gotta get out of here. Gotta get out now. I've had enough. Gotta break.
Hero, snap out of it.
Koto, what are you doing here?
What?
Hey, does this look familiar?
That's my crystal ball.
But it's all smashed. What the hell?
The heck?
I only bought it because the guy said it was bland. He said it was unbreakable. So how did it break? Was it actually just made of glass and not crystal? That guy totally duped me. He said it belonged to the pillars of history. Genghis Khan, George Washington, Napoleon. He said whoever controlled that crystal ball controlled the world. Was it seriously all BS? Let's put that aside for now. So you can say, without a doubt, this belonged to you? Yeah, that's mine for sure. I probably forgot it in the laundry room last night. Someone must have come by and snatched it.
You left it in the laundry room? That means anyone could have found it and taken it. Thanks, Hero. That's all I wanted to know. Sure. By the way, I'm almost afraid to ask, but how much did you pay for that thing? Everything I saved up from fortune telling for 2 full years came out to be like $1 million. $1 million? That's pretty cheap, actually. I mean, considering it gives you the power to control the world. It's just too stupid. I can't even feel bad for him. So, time's up.
I'm getting tired of waiting. What say we just get started, It's time for the long-awaited class trial! Now then, allow me to appoint a proper location for the proceedings. Please go through the red door on the first floor of the school. See you soon!
Red door on the first floor. That's where I should go. No, where I have to go. There it is. The big, ominous red door. This is where our fate is going to be decided. Where we are going to find out, or at least try and find out, who killed Sayaka. And we're not going to do it this time. Oh, no, no, no. This is going to be a very, very special episode next time. If you want to find out who killed Sayaka, you will have to keep watching. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.